What's going on, guys? It's Kyle with DTOM Knives and Gear. And if you look down in the description, or the title, whatever you want to call it, you will see that we're talking about a little knife. And when I say little knife, I mean tiny. Jake, over at Bearded Gear, one of my best friends at this point, not only in the knife community, but in my life in general. Guide and explain our guy love, that's all it is. Guy love, he's mine, I'm his. There's nothing gay about it in our eyes. Thought it would be funny to send the guy with the big hands the little baby knife. We send each other knives back and forth, and sometimes we throw in a surprise knife. Usually for me and him, it's something humongous because he doesn't like the big humongous knife. He likes big knives, don't get me wrong, but the ridiculous, you know, crazy son of bitches, you know, he's not all into that. And this is what he sent me. Now, this is the Ace Riv, the Giant Mouse Ace Riv, and it's been out for a little while. It is very reminiscent of the Biblio, basically a smaller Biblio, and the Biblio was a small knife. This is just stupid small, but I totally get why people like this guy. You know, small knives, fifth pocket knives, this one would be a great fifth pocket knife, backup knives, secondary knives, whatever you want to call it. This is what this role is. This is not going to be somebody's this could definitely be an everyday carry if you do lighter tasks and you're just opening up boxes and occasionally cut cardboard and whatnot. I mean, this will do it. I mean, almost any knife will do it with good blade geometry, which this has, by the way, and we'll get into that. But it's a small knife, backup knife, right? So I would carry what I call a regular size folder and then carry this either in the fifth pocket, the back pocket, and I even have a little side pocket sometimes that I carry it in. And I carried it, and I used it, and as that roll, it doesn't do that bad. I mean, it's, you know, it's a Giant Mouse. I like Giant Mouse products. They do quite a few things right, in my opinion. One of the things they do right is the crowned spine with, and also where they place their jimping. Now, this one is, you know, just like the rest, where in my hands, that jimping is up here, and I feel it, but it's not grippy at all. It's like, it's absolutely smooth, really. So not very aggressive to give you any grip, but it kind of gives you an index on where you're at, which is fine for something like this. And the ergos, if you can see here, the profile of this little guy, typical, but like I said, looks just like a Biblio, right? So it's got to have a finger. I mean, because without a finger troll, it's seriously 2.5 fingers in my hands. And that just doesn't fly. I mean, absolutely, I could cut some stuff with this. I just don't feel comfortable with a 2.5 finger knife. Can be done. A lot of people probably do it. But you do have a finger troll. I love finger trolls. I prefer finger trolls on everything. So it's got one. And I can choke up. Now, because I have very fat fingers, it's basically touching the edge for my fingers. It's still doable because I choke up, but yet choke back to keep my finger off of that. And I can use this knife and do a lot of tasks. Now, obviously, with a small knife comes a very small blade. So you're not going to be doing all kinds of stuff. But like I said, an EDC secondary knife or very light duty task, this will do it. Now, I'm not saying the build quality is such where you can't do hard tasks. It's the design and the size. The build quality from Giant Mouse, is this one of the one made in Italy? I can't remember if this is made in Italy or by Riot. That's way to go review, Kyle. Did I write it down? Riot. I did write it down. It's made by Riot. You guys know that I'm a huge fan of Riot knives. Now, this one, can I tell a huge difference in the build quality between this, the Biblio, or the Ace Grand? Not really. It's definitely a good thing being made by Riot, because I'd rather it be made by Riot than in Italy. Just haven't really had a whole lot of good experience, I guess, with Italy-made knives. They're just not very consistent. I know that these will be because they're made by Riot. But the build quality is excellent. This one is a frame lock. So, very tiny frame lock. Deep carry wire clip, which does not sit all the way to the end of the knife. I don't care about that. But I know some people have really kind of been aggravated about this. Jake is definitely a go-to-the-butt-of-the-knife kind of guy. But on this knife, I know he would prefer it, but it's not like a deal-breaker. But I love a deep carry loop-over wire clip because it's just the most functional one out there. You have 3D milled pocket clips, even if they're deep carry. Even the titanium bent loop-over pocket clips, just, in my opinion, are not as comfortable or function as good as the wire clip. I'm just a huge fan of it. I know it doesn't look as good as some of the titanium wire clips that we have, or the titanium bent wire clips we have out there. And I sometimes want that. But I just can't deny the functionality and great in the pocket, not going to snag on anything kind of things that you get with a wire clip. So we've already kind of talked about the ergonomics. I mean, obviously the ergonomics on this is not going to be good for me. They're not horrible, okay? Because Jesper Voxnes, one of the guys behind the knife, he knows how to make an ergonomic knife. Like I said, my fat sausage fingers goes right up on that edge, so I do have to kind of choke back to get my finger a little bit lower. But when I do that, I can cut with this knife. Now, it's still my pinky is on that point. When I wrap my fingers around it and I'm in that choked up position, it's on this little point. And it's got a radius on it, but I think it could have been bigger because that actually pokes me a little bit. I mean, I'm not doing a lot of hard work, so it doesn't bother me that much. But whenever I have this grip and I'm, that actually I consider to be a hot spot for me. Now, of course, it's just the nature of the beast with a small knife and big hands. Not everything is great, but everything else, you know, The micarta is done very well. The titanium is done very well. There could definitely be more rounding on it, but you can definitely see the chamfering around. It's not horrible at all. It does have a titanium backspacer with a lanyard hole, and this is a knife I can see a lot of people putting a lanyard on to help give them a little bit more grip in the hand. I've seen a lot of people do that with the smaller knives. I'm not a lanyard guy. I do have it on a couple of knives. Well, actually, only one now. So, you know, that's probably appreciated on this. I still think they could have got this a little higher, but, and not, you know, done anything with the, you know, God, I can't talk. The lanyard hole is in the backspacer, so it's out of the way. This one also is a flipper and hole deployment, which was not the Biblio. So that is super cool. I like to have multiple ways to, open a knife. A flipper only usually gets boring to me. And then, of course, a flipper without a choil can really make my hand feel cramped and kind of poke me. But this one, I never carried like this. I always held it like this anyways when I cut something. But let's see, what is the action like with the flipper? It's absolutely wonderful. The detent is tuned really well. Again, Riot. Really, really nice. Flies out of there every time. But, of course, with a hole, this nicely shaped hole that is reminiscent of Giant Mouse Designs, works amazingly. Now, it's not, you know, it's not the most comfortable and the most intuitive because it's so small, but I get it in my hand. I know where I'm at. I can flick it out, and it's a lot of fun. The closing action is not drop shut. Don't expect it to be. But it is very smooth running on bearings. The only problem that I have with this knife most of the time that actually is aggravating to me, probably wouldn't bother a lot of people, is whenever I deploy it, whether it be the flipper or the hole, when I try to get it out of the way, that happens. To get on my finger and then try to get, you know, kind of shake it down. A lot of the times, it doesn't go all the way down, and then I'm trying to shake it, and it double clutches and comes back up. That annoys the shit out of me. But, you know, I can't really knock the knife too much with that because, you know, it's a smaller knife and it's just kind of the nature of the beast. But I don't like that. See, I just don't. That bugs me. So I, most of the time whenever I was closing the knife, I would get the lock bar out of the way and then kind of do this number, which works fine. Just not as fidgety. Just one of those things. One of the, also the great things about this knife is the blade geometry. I mean, it's only, it's like 120 thousandths blade stock and comes down to like 15 thousandths behind the edge. So on a smaller knife, that's great. Full flat grind, Ilmax steel. And, you know, as far as a cutter slicer for your little task, it does great. Just kind of show you on paper. Slices really well. show you on some cardboard. Slices right through it. Does an excellent job as far as those little slicing tasks. Go ahead. I'm not going to do the twisted sit-saw rope, but I am going to do some paracord. It does amazing as far as those slicing tasks. It is definitely small enough to where you can really get behind this blade, do detail work like this. It passes the Ben Peterson finger test, that's for sure. You know, little pinch, pinch grips and all that works amazing. It doesn't really work well for like a reverse grip or reverse draw cut, nothing like that. It's not going to be comfortable. Not for me anyways. if you had midget hands, then yes, you could probably do that. But if you have regular size hands, I just don't think it's going to work for anybody like that. so anyways, let's turn the camera around and get some size comparisons to some knives that I consider to be the small knives. The ones that I can carry as secondary or backup knives in my EDC compared to what this looks like. And then we'll also get some specs and a closer look at this beautiful tiny little bastard, the Giant Mouse Ace Riv. Righty. Look at it in the circle. Holy shit. It's tiny. Very, very small. But in typical Giant Mouse, as far as the Ace line is concerned, the micarta, I love. They do a really good job with their micarta. I love this particular kind. This is the OD green or green, whatever kind of green they call it. Soaks up the oils and changes color. I love it. I really, really do. And then, of course, a titanium frame lock. Blasted surfaces. You know, there you see your chamfering. The radiuses are very small, but they are radiused. There is your jimping on that blade. Just, you know, a well-built knife. That's for sure. There is your blade shape. Love the blade shape. Very utilitarian. And I just, these are the kind of blade shapes that I really enjoy. This I call still a leaf-shaped blade. And then, of course, your opening. Oh, gee whiz, camera. You see it does have chamfering around there. So it is very comfortable, very nice to flick out. And it does it well. Like I said, I've got to get it in my hand a certain way, but it deploys 100% of the time. The detent, as far as the flipper, it's good. I love the detent. Might be a little strong for some because I do slip off of it because it is so small. It's a very tiny flipper, but that's great if you're going for the minimalist carry because this guy is so tiny. If it had a huge flipper tag stepping out of there, I think it would defeat the purpose. So what are we talking about? Let's fit right in there. Look at there. It's an overall length of 5.75 inches. Damn. It's got a blade length of only 2.44 inches. Damn. But like I said, 120 thousandths blade stock that comes down to 15 thousandths behind the edge. It makes for an excellent slicer. You're not going to get a lot of blade length to do a lot of tasks, but for the majority of us in the little tasks that we have throughout the day, this blade will do you fine if this fits your hand enough to where you're comfortable carrying it. It does an excellent job. The blade is a nice stonewash. I do like Giant Mouse's stonewash. However, most of them have seen or that I've had have been made in Italy. This is Riot. Riot, of course, killed it. So really, really like that. These things are about $185. That is kind of steep, but it's Riot made, and that price, I totally get it. And yes, I think it's worth that. Kind of getting ahead of ourselves a little bit. But let's go ahead and put it up against some of the knives that I consider to be my small knives, okay, my backup knives. First, one of my favorites, and you guys already know what it is, the F5.5, also made by Riot, a gift from Kevin Lefty EDC. So as you can see, my small knife is making, or the Riv is making my small knife look like a giant. That's how small this knife is, and I can't get over it. Another one that you will see a review coming soon on is the Quiet Carry Drift. Drift looks humongous, right? Another one that I really have enjoyed, you guys know, because this one won one of my budget knives of the year in 2020. This is the Ferrum Forge Stinger. Definitely a longer knife on that one. And also has the finger troll. So as you can see, the ergonomics on the Stinger really work for my large size hands. And it is still a compact size, pretty thin. This guy's a little bit chunkier. And then the last one I want to put it up against is the Wingman. This is the Mach 1. Very nice, small package knife, but still, it's still so much longer and bigger than the damn Riv. It's just freaking small. I do not have an interest in picking one of these up, guys, because it is so small. Because they make things like the knives that I just showed you. Knives that in my hands really, you know, fit a lot better when I can choke up like this on a flat or choke up like this on a finger troll, but still have enough handle to where I feel so locked in and comfortable on those guys. The Drift, the F5.5, all of those really work well for my hand size. And this one could work. It's not ideal. It's just not ideal for me. But yes, I can recommend this knife absolutely for a lot of people who want that smaller form factor fifth pocket knife. We did not do, I always forget the weight, guys, so we'll go ahead and tell you what this weighs, because a lot of you minimalists out there are going to be concerned about that. You want something small, it goes in your pocket, but how much does it weigh? Because it, you know, micarta, but it's a full titanium frame lock, and if I remember correctly, yeah, there is no internal milling on this guy. It weighs 2.45 ounces. It is a 2.44 inch blade. So an ounce per inch standard is there. So I don't think there could be any complaints about the Giant Mouse Ace Riv in this category. Not at all. Guys, I appreciate you stopping by. Jake, you are the man for sending it to me. I'm glad I got to check it out. Obviously, it's not for me, but we all knew that from the point. But I can honestly say this is a good knife. Absolutely. I am a fan of Giant Mouse knives. The Ace, I have a couple. I have the Ace Sonoma, and then I have the Ace Grand. So yes, I am a fan. They make great products. This one made by Riot just makes it even better. Stay safe, guys, in this crazy world that we are living in, and we will see you in the next one.